Are you creating an application extension to customize your Oracle Cloud application? Or maybe building a web or mobile app? Here's some basic information about Workspaces, Git repositories, and what's going on behind the scenes as you work in the designer. In Visual Builder Studio, or VB Studio for short, you do most of your work in a private area called a workspace. The workspace brings together everything you need to build a web app, mobile app, or application extension in the designer. In most cases, someone else will have set up a project for the work you and others will do on this app or app extension. Among other things, this project stores all the source files for your team's work in a Git repository. You have a copy of those files in your workspace, but the project's copy, also known as the remote repository, is always the source of truth. Each of your team members has a workspace with a copy of the files, too. A workspace repo is also known as a local repository. You can think of a Git repository as a tree structure, similar to the folder structure on your PC. You do your work in a branch of that tree. Everything you do in the designer's user interface is actually stored as code in your current branch. So you might have one branch for feature A that you're working on by yourself, and a different branch for feature B that you're collaborating on with a colleague. Within your workspace, it's very common to switch back and forth between branches frequently as work priorities shift. However, your workspace can only be pointed to a single branch at a time. All the changes you make to a branch are completely confined to your local repository. How do you share your work with others? There are different answers to this question depending on whether you're in the development phase, test phase, or if you're pretty much done with your work. Let's take a look at the development phase first. For others to see your work, you must first push the code in your branch to the corresponding branch in the remote repository. During development, you typically do this with a Git push action. Once you've done this, others can then set their current branch to your branch, then do a Git pull to copy that branch to their local repo. This allows them to see your code in their own local repository. If instead they wanted to add your code to their own branch, they'd do a Git merge instead of a Git pull. It's very common to do Git pulls and pushes many times a day as you work with others to develop a code base. Let's take a look at the designer. Once you're satisfied with the changes you've made in your branch and you're ready to test, you can do so privately by clicking Preview. This lets you see everything in your current branch in action. After testing privately, you'll probably want to share your changes with others who can review and test further. To do this, click Share, which creates a URL you can give to your testers. If you're working on an application extension and are using a sandbox, which you need only when you want to expose unpublished business object changes in your UI, you need to give your testers the name of the sandbox as well. Once everyone signs off on your work and you're ready to make it public, just click Publish Changes. Depending on how your admin has set things up, you may be asked to create a merge request before you can publish your changes. This gives others an opportunity to sign off on your work before it becomes part of the master code base. If you get a message that says there are merge conflicts, that means that your work is going to overwrite the work that someone else is trying to publish to the repo. If that happens, talk to a developer who can help you resolve it. Then just click Publish again to continue. That's it. Thanks for watching. Learn more at docs.oracle.com.